मैच नहीं करता, ठीक है, तो इसीलिए उसको थोड़ा ध्यान से करो। बिग डम्बल इज प्रिपेयर्ड बाय यूजिंग यूनिफॉर्म रॉड ऑफ मास 60 ग्राम एंड लेंथ इज 20 सेंटीमीटर। तो सो फर्स्ट वी विल ड्रॉ अबाउट अ रॉड। दिस इज व्हाट अ रॉड सपोज। It is given that the mass of the rod it is equal to 60 grams and the length of the rod is 20 centimeters. Then two identical solid sphere of mass 15 grams and radius 10 centimeters each are at the two ends of the rod. So two alag alag sphere hai, dono ka configuration same hai. So I will draw two separate spheres like this. Okay, they are attached to the end of the rod, but अभी फिलहाल के लिए मैं उसको अटैच नहीं कर रहा। Actually, what is the complete system? The complete system is like this. This is what a sphere here, and a sphere to the another side like this. And there is what a rod in between. So that ये dumbbell बन जाता है। So this is the question, and this is now set into rotation. So what is given? This is what 50 grams and radius it is equal to 10 centimeter. The same in this case, mass it is equal to 50 grams and radius it is equal to 10 centimeter. Calculate the moment of inertia of the dumbbell when rotated about an axis passing through its center and perpendicular to the length. So this is the axis which is passing through the center and perpendicular to the length. So ये axis आपको calculate करना है, so this axis is to be calculated. ठीक है, so we will write the data. What is given in the data? The data by सबसे पहले rod का specification, the mass of the rod you can say 60 grams and length of the rod you can say is 20 centimeters. Then we'll consider sphere. Mass of the sphere is equal to 50 grams and radius of the sphere it is equal to 10 centimeters. So all the things are in CGS unit, so no need to convert. आपका जो I रहेगा वो भी CGS unit रहेगा, kg meter square meter के लिए grams centimeter square. So to find is what? To find is I. Find is I equals question mark. So what is the formula? For rod we know. For rod I it is equal to ml square divided by 12. For sphere also we know. For sphere I it is equal to, this is for rod you can say I R. This you can write as IR and this you can write as IS because it is of sphere. So for sphere, the axis which is passing through and the axis which is passing through the center and like this, the axis, this is 2 by 5 mass square. 2 by 5 mass square. Okay, masses and radius and length are what? Given and they are different. I want to get for the complete system. So what I will do is I will calculate individual. I will calculate one individual. Okay. तो सबसे पहले rod का केस कंसिडर करेंगे तो I का वैल्यू क्या रहेगा? I will be equal to I of rod plus I of sphere with axis at center of rod. That means we know this axis. We know this axis. This axis is what 2 by 5 mR square. So this axis, about this axis we want to get. So kya parallel axis theorem apply karna padega, right? Parallel axis theorem apply karna padega. So ek kaam karo, itna likh lo, then main ye shapes ko rough kar dunga and after that we will solve the problem. Okay. So what is the total distance here? The total distance it is equal to, यहाँ से लेके यहाँ तक का डिस्टेंस कितना है? The length of the rod it is what 20 centimeters, उसका हाफ कितना हो जाएगा 10 centimeter, and the radius, it is what? The radius, it is what? 10 centimeter, right? The radius, it is what? 10 centimeter. The total distance will be 20 centimeters. This is what 30 centimeters. And how many spheres are there? There are two spheres. So we have to apply parallel axis here. Okay? So instead of IS, you can say it is what I zero. And kitni bar hai? Do bar hai. So 2 multiplied by I zero. Okay, 2 multiplied by I zero. What is I zero? I zero is this. Suppose these two are the spheres. I zero, it is only one of them. The center of mass, the center of the rod is there. The distance between this is what 20. It's the distance it is what 20. That is the value of h. This is the value of IC. IC is equal to 2 by pi m r square. And this is the value of I zero. I zero it is equal to IC plus m h square divided by m h square. So it is not parallel axis. Okay. So you start writing. Individually we can solve. Moment of inertia of rod, it is equal to ml square divided by 12. So moment of inertia of rod, it is a mass of the rod is 60 into L square. L square it is what? 20 into 20 divided by 12. So this is 10 and this will be 2. And this will be 10 again. And the answer here it is 2000. So moment of inertia of rod is what? 2000 gram centimeter square. This is in CGS units. Now you calculate the value of I zero. I zero it is equal to IC plus MH square. I zero it is IC. What is the value of IC? IC is 2 by 5 m r square plus MH square. So this is 2 by 5. M mass of the sphere, that is 50. So 50 into r square, radius of the sphere is 10. This is 10 multiplied by 10 plus mh square. So mass of the sphere again is equal to 50 into h square, the distance between the two. The distance is about 20, so we can write 20 into 20. Okay. So you have to solve this. This will be 5 1 5 1 5. So this is 5 × 50. So पहला क्या आया आपका I zero में? I zero में first term आ गया आपका 2000 है. So first term is 2000 plus what is the next term here? 5 × 10. 100. 1000, 20,000. So next is what? 20,000. So what is the value of I zero then? I zero is equal to 22,000. Okay. So this is the value of I zero. But there are what? Two spheres. So हमने सिर्फ एक ही side का consider किया, दूसरे side का consider करेंगे तो multiply by 2 हो जाएगा, right? So what is the value of I then? I is equal to I of rod plus 2 times I zero. So I it is equal to I of rod is 2000 plus 2 multiplied by this I zero is how much? 22000. So this is equal to 2000 plus 4400. This will be equal to 4600 gram centimeter square. So this is the answer. Okay. This is not matching the textbook. You can so you can complete this fast. Okay, if you have any doubt, please ask. Or if suppose you want one more time the solution, I can give you. सांची आपको समझ में आ गया कैलकुलेशंस?
हाँ सर।
Is all of you completed writing? Okay, thank you. So I'm once again I will explain this thing, this numerical. So what is the total system? Hence what two spheres are there and one rod is there. The moment of inertia about the central axis is to be calculated. Moment of inertia about the central axis is to be calculated. So I will consider different cases. First, I will consider rod. I will solve the moment of inertia about its central axis first. This is given by height is equal to ml squared divided by 12. While in the next part, I will consider the sphere and I will calculate the moment of inertia about the same axis, and this will be called as I0, and I0 will be equal to IC plus MH squared, where IC is this I see it is equal to 2/5 mR² and mass is known to us, mass is equal to 50 and h is this, this is h. H is what, 20 centimeter. Okay. But there is not only one square, there are what, two squares. So instead of I0, I will consider 2I0. Okay. So what is the total moment of inertia? What's the total moment of inertia? Moment of inertia of complete system. It is equal to I of rod plus 2 times I0. Okay. So I will consider I rod first. I will solve this I rod first. I rod is equal to mL² divided by 12. Rod ki case mein this is what 60, L square it is what 20 into 20 divided by 12. So ye kitna aata hai, ye hame aata hai, this is what 2000 gram centimeter square. This is the value of I rod. Then we will calculate what is the value of I0. What is the value of I0? I0 is equal to IC plus mH² and IC is equal to 2/5 mR² plus M into H². Okay? So we substitute the values 2/5 M, it is 50. R² will be 10 into 10, that will be 10² plus M, again it is 50 and this is about 20 into 10. So this 5 will get cancelled, this will be 10 and this we are getting 2000. 50 into 20 it is 1000 and multiplied by 20 it is 20,000. So here I am getting 20,000. So the answer is 22,000. That's the value of I0. But what we should do with this is there are two spheres, so total I it is equal to I of rod plus I of rod plus 2 times I0. I of rod is 2000 plus 2 multiplied by I0 is 2200. So this is 2000 plus 4400. The answer is 46,000. This is the answer. This is in gram centimeter square. So I hope you have understood this all things. Okay. So you can take a screenshot. This is the easiest way. Okay. So पहले वाले केस में डेटा था, टू फाइंड था, फॉर्म था, ये सबसे बड़ा बड़ा था, बट दैट इज व्हाट द सिंपल एक्सप्लेनेशन. You can take a screenshot. We are going to move to the next question. अगर दोनों जगह अलग अलग स्पेयर रखते तो अलग अलग लेना पड़ता है. अगर सपोज इसका मास अलग है, दिस मास इज व्हाट सपोज m1, दैट मास इज व्हाट m2, दिस मास इज व्हाट m1, रेडियस इज व्हाट r1, हियर मास इज व्हाट m2, रेडियस इज व्हाट r2, देन वी शुड कंसीडर दैट दिस इज व्हाट सबनेट I0. सो I0 - I0 डबल - ओके. सो उसके हिसाब से वी विल इंटीग्रल सॉल्व दिस. दोनों का कैलकुलेट करना पड़ता है, दिस दोनों का कैलकुलेट. Okay. Any more doubts? Anyone having a doubt, please ask me. Okay. If there is no doubt, please give a feedback on the chat and we'll move to the next question. Has all of you understood and taken the screenshot?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Good. Good. Yeah. So we are moving to the next one.